A New Jersey, so from Chinese New Year, here's a Valentine's Day story. New Jersey, or not so much. A New Jersey animal shelter takes an unusual step to help control the population of feral cats. For a $50 donation, the Homeward Bound Pet Adoption Center gives the name of an ex-flame to a community cat, which is then spayed or neutered, vaccinated, and released back to the community. As a result, there are just now many Jeffs, Mikes, Ians, and Tylers, and even one cat named Gaslight Guy roaming around Camden County. The Neuter Your Ex campaign was proposed by one of the shelter's volunteers, and due to the enthusiastic response, it will be extended past Valentine's Day. Around 100,000 local and foreign tourists are expected to join the Chinese New Year festivities in Quezon City. The QC local government is mounting a three-day event beginning February 9, that's tomorrow, in its very own Chinatown district on Banawe Street. This year's celebrations will include a three-hour cultural tour, which will showcase the district's rich Chinese-Filipino culture, landmarks such as the Buddhist temple, as well as the Filipino-Chinese friendship arcs called Pai Fang, will be open for public's viewing. Over 30 participating merchants will also present a variety of Chinese delicacies and crafts. The Quezon City Police District will be deploying 200 police personnel to ensure security during the event. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department expecting appointments for its services to return to pre-pandemic levels this year. The passports issued in 2023 reached over 3 million. That is still a million less than the 2019 figure of 4,095,000. It also touts improvement in processing times, which is down to as short as 5 to 10 working days from the previous 7 to 12. The DFA also saw a surge in the issuance of a certificate that authenticates the origin of a public document. Meanwhile, Philippine visa issuance remains lagging behind pre-pandemic figures. The agency now eyeing to further streamline appointment processes by developing an e-visa system. State Weather Bureau Pagasa says the El Niño phenomenon is now in its mature stage. It notes while the weather event may weaken in the latter part of the first quarter, its impact, though, including a great reduction in rainfall and heat, will continue to persist. Pagasa says 2023 was the 11th warmest year for the Philippines in history, and 2024's dry season may just be characterized by even warmer temperatures due to El Niño. Meanwhile, the Philippine Health Department is warning the public against extreme heat. People could experience heat cramps and heat exhaustion due to the weather condition. And while there's much less rainfall during an El Niño, the spread of dengue is still possible because most people will likely store water that become potential breeding grounds for dengue-carrying mosquitoes. While the Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, or TESDA, is known for offering traditional courses on cooking, carpentry, and electrical work, the agency is now offering a course on content creation to help Filipinos make the most of online livelihood opportunities. Victoria Tulad walks us through that course. Watch this.
19-year-old Athena Joyce Apolinario has been a content creator since 2020. At first, it was just for fun, but now, Athena is also able to monetize her posts.
May mga nag-reach out po sa akin ng mga local brands na i-endorse ko raw po yung mga products nila. Ito, nakakuha po ako ng konting commission. Pandagdag sa school po, mga para po sa miscellaneous.
Content creation is also a source of income for Karen Torres Basco, who has been in the industry for 8 years. Her daughter joins her shoots.
Naging bonding pa namin ni nung anak ko. Nakakapag-adjust ako kung kailan ako mag-work, kung kailan ako mag-shoot.
Due to the demand for content creation, the Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, or TESDA, considers it as a key employment generator. As such, the agency created a course for content creation with the help of the Kapisana ng Social Media Broadcasters ng Pilipinas.
They were the ones who requested TESDA to develop the standards. So they want to professionalize the content creators to prevent proliferations of fake news, to have a standard and best practice for content creation.
The course on content creation was launched in December 2023. But at the moment, only one school in the country has applied for registration. TESDA hopes that more institutions will follow and that classes will begin soon. Students will primarily be taught about producing social media content.
wanted to establish really the competencies of a person if he faces people and he does social influencing. Yung competencies on research, competencies on translating mga concepts, and of course yung ano din, yung marketing your content.
Classes include computer operations, entrepreneurial skills, and occupational safety and health work practices. There's no educational requirement for students who would like to enroll. They should, however, be at least 15 years old. The course lasts for 140 hours or 17.5 days. Tuition will depend on the school, but scholarships may be offered. According to Urdaneta, credits of the course can be used for higher education.
And things can be credited for the collegiate level. Na later, they can use in order to finish yung mass comm degree later.
For Athena and Karen, the course will be a huge help.
Matulungan po ako na paano mag-time management since nag-aaral po ako habang nagka-content creator. And yung sa editing po, para po mas mapaganda yung pag-i-edit.
So kung meron kasama sa instructions nila, sa manual nila na hindi ko pa alam, I would love to learn that.
Those interested may visit the TESDA website for more information on the course. Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.
Mayor of Matanog in Maguindanao del Norte is seeking the private sector support for the city's WELL program, which assists women and children heavily affected by past armed conflicts in the area. Mayor Zoraya Bansil-Gudo believes that supporting this program will ensure compliance with a landmark 2014 peace accord, which ended an armed rebellion in the southern Philippine region long plagued by insurgency.
Nagsimula po ito sa parang yung mga kababaihan na kaligtaan na pinakamalaking apektado nung war na yan, nung all-out war. Nakaligtaan sila na sila pala yung masyadong naapektuhan. Sila yung namatayan ng asawa, namatayan ng kapatid. Isang sagot kasi sa itong katahimikan ay yung education. So nagputap din po kami ng education sa mga anak nila, mga institution, yung higher education para maipasok natin yung kanilang mga anak.
A bill that allows the use of cannabis or marijuana for medical purposes passed by the Joint House Committees of Health and Dangerous Drugs on Wednesday. Under the measure, medical cannabis will only be issued by licensed doctors to patients with debilitating diseases or medical conditions that can cause severe weakness. The drug can also be prescribed to cure non-debilitating diseases such as anxiety and severe insomnia upon the authorization of the physician.
Ang aming inaprubahan ay exclusive lamang po ito for medical use. Medical cannabis in pharmaceutical form ang inaalaw po natin dito. So this will treat debilitating diseases as identified by the physicians. And there's a proposal also to include yung non-debilitating. Ang example na binigay nila ay yung anxiety, no? Or severe insomnia.
Aside from this, a medical cannabis office will also be established, which will regulate the issuance of permits and licenses to health facilities and professionals qualified to prescribe or release medical cannabis. Offenders will be liable to a fine of as much as 1 million pesos and up to 6 years of jail time. Senior leader of Iran-backed militia killed in a U.S. airstrike in Iraq on Wednesday, the Pentagon says. The man was a leader of Kataib Hezbollah, the group that officials blamed for the drone attack in Jordan last month, which killed 3 American service members and injured over 40 others. The Iraq-based group, which also is considered by the U.S. as a terrorist organization, is considered a proxy of Iran.